All right. And I think we can get this podcast started. Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Fist Bump Podcast. I am your host, Chronicos, also known as Brody. I'm from the Super Smash Brothers community, and I am a commentator from that group. Joining me, I have two of my friends. I have Max and Dawson, also known as Karama and Ultimate Juice. I got the tags backwards, but they'll introduce themselves and set that straight for me. So without further ado, we're going to start with Max, and then let those introductions get underway.
All right, hi, my name is Max. I go by Maximus12 on Twitch. I am a speedrunner of the FNAF series currently. I have one speedrun time of 1 hour, 22 minutes, and 3 seconds. I've been to multiple Smash runs in my life. Biggest one I've been to would be, correct me if I'm wrong, Canada Cup?
Canada Cup 2019, I think it was, right?
2019 or 2020, then yeah. I went to Smash Ryzen 2 also.
Yeah. Both relatively local events, but they were still good events nonetheless. I mean, we had MKLeo come out. We got to meet freaking MKLeo, so it's a really good event.
I still have a picture with him.
I have my picture. Yeah, he's so cool.
But the characters I play in Smash are Dark Samus, Ike, WeeFit, and recently I've been picking up Terry.
Let's go. All right, and then we'll get on to our third member of the group here. We got Dawson, so take it away.
Hello, everyone, and my name is Dawson, as you just heard. But you guys also may know me as Karama. I have appeared in many of Brody's blogs. I am also I'm also his tournament assistant. And I regularly play Zelda, Incineroar, and a newcomer for my roster of characters is Wolf. And I think the most notable tournament I was in of recently was probably one of Brody's tournaments, to be honest.
Fair. But you have been a Battle of BC5, so I think that's a pretty it's a pretty epic staple.
It is an epic one.
So welcome, everybody. This is the group that we're going to be doing the podcast as of today. We're choosing to do this podcast mainly because it is a little bit to test the waters, kind of see how things run. But it's also a little bit of an advertisement, I guess, in a way, because we're talking about our final Smash tournament, guys. This has been going on for 8 years of our lives. Like, high school.
Final Smash tournament.
It's the last one. We've ran up to 50 tournaments, I think, throughout this friend group throughout our lives. And yeah, it's a pretty decent number. We've been in the double digits for nearly a decade, so it's been kind of nice.
We old.
Yeah, we're unironically getting a little bit old here. It's kind of funny. So, without that, without further ado, what is Smash Bros to our friend group? So, I was the first person to kind of bring Smash Bros into the friend group. I did a lot of relative things that kind of like pumped the friend group into kind of like getting excited about the game and whatnot. I had a game club that I ran in high school, and I've been to many Smash tournaments in my life. My first tournament that I ever got to go to was a single elimination tournament in a library in our downtown local city. I ended up winning the whole tournament somehow, and I have been a Smash player pretty much ever since then. I took a little bit of a retirement in 2022 to 2023 because I was getting a little tired of playing the game, but I am back in the game. So for a lot of people that don't know, I did step out of retirement to come back and play a little bit more Toon Link lately, and things have been looking pretty good for me. I've been relatively excited to get back into the game.
Well, I should say been better than looking pretty good. I say they're looking pretty amazing, Mr. Top 100 Toon Link.
Oh yeah, I guess I'm 95th Toon Link in the world now. So that's,
yeah, Mr. Link.
Yeah, you know what? Actually, like it's pretty inspiring to see myself on a list that big. So I do take it with a grain of salt that like the effort really did pay off. But I mean, it's not like you guys are slouching very much either. Like Dawson's got an amazing Zelda, and he does so much work against a lot of the friend group. And Max plays like a huge variety of characters, and he almost took out one of our local players, Shadowroth, in a friendlies warm up, which was it was kind of hype. Yeah. You've taken games off of Dax.
So here's how that went down. It started off as just a casual warm up for me and Chad. We're playing, but for me that wasn't a warm up. I'm gonna be honest here. I was like, I gotta take Chad out at least once in my life in a tournament right?
yeah.
So eventually, I started to take the lead, and then I'm already in full gamer lead mode at this point. Then our buddy Prophet Mountain Dew comes over and he sees. He walks over to you, says something. Then all of a sudden, me and Shad both notice we have everyone at the tournament watching us play. And then hype. I see Shad do his gamer lead, and I'm like, oh no. And then I got Rosad.
He really
that,
did.
That reminds me of when I went to Shad's tournament, and everyone was around me.
That's true, because you had one of the most close upsets in that whole bracket. No,
like,
I almost
won, too, game.
You were playing Zelda against one of our well-known Pikachu players. It was also one of those sets where you were absolutely the underdog. No one knew who you were. You're playing a very niche character, and all of a sudden, like, this room is just crowded with people potentially watching the biggest upset of the day. It was hype. It was really hype.
I was like, I'm actually not bad at the game.
All of us are good at the game. We just don't play a lot. It's a lot of, like, what keeps a lot of the players back. But going into other players that are good in our friend group, we also have the Sweat Slayer, one of the most well-known video editors in the entire Smash community right now.
Did he make 2%
milk? 3%
milk.
Yeah, 3% milk. He edited that video, thank God, because that was a really good meme from our friend group. But going back onto the topic, he is our second strongest player in the friend group as of right now. Currently he plays Steve. He's got a Byleth in the back. He's got Zero Suit Samus, Peach. He's got some scary, scary characters. He likes his top tiers.
He definitely does. I agree with you on that one. Mm-hmm. Every time I've played against his Steve, I can't seem to find a way in.
It's tough.
All I've heard from him is that he's scared, terrified of my Zelda, and that's it.
Yeah, Zelda's really good.
That's because you're Zelda, and Zelda can easily beat Steve. I believe Zelda actually wins that matchup.
I don't know.
No, okay, low-key, Phantom gets fucked over by just building a block.
I don't think Zelda wins, but I definitely think that Zack has a mental block against Zelda. So I feel like that is more of a factor than doing good against Steve, because Steve as a character is kind of gross. Like, we can be honest, boys. That character is
that guy's banned in some places for a reason. Let's just say that.
Yeah. Hashtag Lethbridge Punch, please. Welcome to the podcast. I gotta imagine him popping off. He's like, that's me. but yeah, like, back to our friend group, like, a lot of us started off as people who just, like, we were just a bunch of people who went to this farmer-ass high school, and we really did not kind of, it's not that we didn't fit in, it's just that we were very unique in the things that we enjoyed in life. And a lot of the other people are just kind of getting ready to graduate and shit, and they're just doing their stuff.
Okay, well, like to be fair, everyone was, like farmer boys, like all country girls, and there's just our like gaming room where we were just gamers.
We were ahead of the curve in terms of like the generation of people that were like involved in a lot of things, but like they were ahead of us too. Like a lot of them were driving tractors and stuff like that. But that was the environment that we were in. So I did a presentation for basically the student council, or I guess it would be the parent. No, it's parent teacher council. I brought in this whole presentation, made it on a PowerPoint. And I was like, we can make this pop off at this school. And all I need to do is just ask you guys to give me a little bit of help, and I can set up a Wii U in one of the teachers' rooms. And they literally said, great, here's $600. It was the best day, because it was like, they literally, like a week later, we had a Wii U, we had Smash Bros. For the Wii U, we had GameCube adapters being bought, we had like 5 to 8 games, like, also, like, just set up, and it was, like, Mario Kart, Smash Bros., Pokken Tournament, like, so many competitive, but, like, fun games that we could run, and we ran Smash every single day. You know for a fact that we had four days where we did not run Smash.
There were some days where I wanted to play Pokken, but we just ended up playing Smash.
We ran it for one day, and everyone didn't like it, because Garchomp was really weird for new players. But aside from that, that was the introduction for a lot of people in this friend group. We have 17 players going into our final Smash tournament, and to say that is like the number that's a really nice number for our friend group to end on, because That happened to be the biggest tournament we ran in high school, funny enough. Was 17 people, including some teachers that actually hopped into, which was pretty hype, not gonna lie. But that's a lot of like our old, like the old past of like our friend group. That was Smash 4. Like, that's a lot of like where that was then. We're like, let's talk a little bit about like where we are now, because I feel like that's also equally important, and it's also why this is the last tournament. So I'm gonna start it off, and then I'll hand it over to Max, but. Because I don't want to try and be the spotlight of the show here, but I want to give you guys a shot at like talking about this too, because I think you guys have different perspectives.
Fair game, mate.
When Smash Ultimate came out, I think we all can agree that this game was phenomenal. It was so fun. All the characters felt fluid. We were trying out new things. Everything felt like it was fun. Dawson's out here trying Ridley and like just enjoying the game. Max is like, I can play Ike and I can really enjoy the content of like what I can do. I can dash at people and Ike doesn't know range and all this great stuff.
Oh, yeah.
And
what did Ike shit in for?
He was low tier for sure. Like he was okay. He was low mid or bottom tier, but he was definitely not a good character. Damn. In Smash Ultimate, every character genuinely has a shot at winning a tournament in this game. I do believe that. Like I think the
that
only characters where I don't
on.
Believe
I
do
heavily
that,
agree with that. Yeah.
I think the only characters where I don't believe that is like Banjo and like characters that just don't have enough representation, like me, Swordfighter. But back into the context of what I'm trying to say. Our friend group has kind of like been in this little limbo for a little while. It's kind of been, I will host the tournament, some people will show up, and we will have a great, fantastic time, but we don't really do much else with it. Like, we just kind of play Smash Bros, and that's kind of all it is. But we're all adults. Like, we have a lot of stuff to do with our lives. We have pretty much everyone's working. I'm in university right now trying to get this freaking degree. Ugh, but it's gross.
The grind is real, mate.
The grind is real for a lot of us, and I feel like that alone has kind of left us in this point where we don't really need to play Smash Bros. To do a lot of the things. We're in Discord a lot. We're playing Lethal Company. We're doing a little bit more casual things now, and it's not a race for us to try and be the top player in our friend group. Like, no one's gunning for my spot in first place anymore, and a lot of people have been kind of just turning off the practice. They don't feel like they either need to practice or they just don't want to play the game. And I feel like that's fair. The game's been out since 2018. Like
oh, shit.
It's been 6 years since Smash Ultimate's been out. December 7th, 2017. Or 2018. Like,
yeah, like, I remember. I even went to the midnight launch of that.
Yeah, like, that tournament was phenomenal. Like, I remember people literally thinking dashing was weird, and now here we are literally thinking dashing is, like, one of the funnest things in the game.
I'm a dash fiend. I've been dash.
Dashing is so fun in Ultimate. Like, it's so fun. Like, they just, I don't know. When I look at it from an outside perspective, they've done a really good job with this game. But, like, when I play competitively, I'm like, wow, I don't want to fight Yone Link or Bowser this week. Sorry, guys. but, like, that's, like,
fuck
it's
that
just
shit.
It's one of those games where it's like, I feel like we've spent so much time playing it that I don't feel like it's necessary for people to say like, oh, I want to spend another 4 more years playing this game. No one in our friend group really wants to say, hey, I've got 3 more years in me. Let's just go hard and let's go to Toronto for a Smash tournament and spend $600 for a weekend. No one is doing that right now in our friend group. I can
promise
you.
Yeah, no one's doing that.
So to kind of wrap up my point, this is the last Smash tournament we are running because I feel like we are at a point where we need to take a break from this game to kind of either re-inspire people to want to bring it up later in our lives, or it ends up being one of those games where it's been one hell of a run and we are so proud of what we've accomplished with the game, but it's just, it's at that point where April 24th might be the last day that a lot of people pick up that controller.
Like low-key, I think the only way we're going to be doing tournaments, because it would be literally Pokemon, because it's more casual than anything.
Pokemon
else
actually is unironically bringing it back for us. I'm not going to lie. There's been more Pokemon tournaments lately than Smash tournaments. So
yeah.
I do agree with that. Yeah. Pokemon could bring it back for us. But let's go to Max. I want to see what Max thinks about like this being the last Smash tournament. Kind of deal.
So for me, when Ultimate did come out and I went to that first midnight launch at our local mall, that local EB, I had a really fun time, but over the years of playing it and stuff like that, a lot of the times I ran into mental blocks that I could not pass for like a whole year or somewhat. And usually those mental blocks, sometimes they really get in people's way. And for me, I'm one of those people. And if I can't get around the mental block, I end up just putting the controller down for a bit, which I have done a few times myself.
Which is definitely fair. It's hard because lot of the characters that you used to fight in brackets were niche, or the counter to your character is really good. So I do understand that point.
Yeah. In my first big break there, I did from Smash was when I really hopped into Apex there.
Yeah, and that was COVID right?
Mm-hmm, yeah, COVID era. That's when I really COVID started hit us hard, grind. Dude.
COVID hit us so hard. Oh man.
But that's when I started really hitting the grind, started playing more games. Then every once in a while, you would message me like, hey, we should do something. I'd be like, Smash? Sure, why not?
Yeah.
Just, it's a game that we could always bounce back to where a bunch of people could play at once. Mm-hmm. And not limited to 4 or 2 people.
I definitely agree with you there.
We can have 8 people play, so that's the best part of it.
Which is good. And that's what made it so good in the first place, right? We could have 8 people in Dylan's basement just hopping on the controllers. We played that shit for hours. Like maybe 6 to 8 hours of a full day. We would spend it just drinking Mountain Dews and just
playing Smash 4.
Literally mashing buttons and finding funny ways to cheese the Yoshi main. Like that was just so much of our teenagehood that I feel like that's what made it so fun as a casual perspective. It's the fun that we can still party game it, but we don't have to take it that seriously anymore. So that's why, I do agree with your point.
And I'm going to go back to with the last point you made there. Well, some players will continue playing. Well, some players will put down the controller for good. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be one of the players that put down the controller for good.
I think so.
Because there's so many more other games that are bring my interest. Yeah. It's like... it's sad because that's a part of me that I'll be putting down for good.
Yeah.
That I started off from Melee all the way up to Ultimate.
Yeah.
Relatable. That's relatable.
I totally get it. It's like, it's been so many years of our lives. Like, I mean, like for me, I started in Brawl and it was like, I just remember thinking like Toon Link's in this fucking video game, dude. And I was like, it made me so happy. Just the idea that I can just play this character and just fall in love with a video game in such a unique, it's almost intimate kind of a way, where it's like you get to play these characters that are from your childhood, and just it really hits home sometimes. I don't know, it's just a wonderful experience.
For me, one of my biggest reason that after this tournament I'll be putting down, I've been through about 3 GCs in total, 2 Smash, then put together as 1.
Damn. Yeah, so
They were smashed because of Smash.
That's honestly fair.
Ironic, isn't it?
And I think we can go to Dawson now too, because I feel like it's your turn, buddy.
Time for your thoughts. My thoughts on this is like, I think we're still gonna play the game. Like, if I'm being honest, we're not gonna just ditch it. We're gonna still. Like, once in a while, like, hey, guys, you know, we haven't played in a while.
He's got the optimist approach. Let's go.
let's play Smash, you know?
I think as, like, a once-in-a-while type of thing, if playing it at a friend, like, get-together, I do agree.
Like, in my honest opinion, I don't think I'm going to put the controller down, if I'm being honest.
Hey, that's kind of hype, though.
Like, I think, like, I haven't been much to turn. I have not been much tournaments, but I kind of want to see what I can still do. Because I'm in the process where I'm like, what the hell can my Zelda do? Or what the hell? Yeah,
so Dawson, you're at the process of when I went to Smash Horizon 2.
Yeah.
Because, like, that process, that whole point of me going to that tournament, Smash Horizon 2, was to see what I'm capable of.
Because, like,
see if I still need to improve.
Because, like, I think I have a really good Zelda. Like, I think it could potentially be up there.
A phenomenal Zelda.
Your Zelda scares most of the group.
Like, I think if I try hard enough, it can, like, definitely be, like, where, like, similar to Brody's, like, Toon Link. I can probably be, like, up there, too.
If you solo main Zelda for a year or two, like, you'd probably pop off big time.
Like, again, like, there's some reasons, like, why. Like, again, I know, like, when we do practice sessions, I don't play Zelda, but it's just for me reason, because, like, I get bored quickly.
Yeah.
Like, that's just a me thing. Like, again, yeah. Like...
I do what, feel like... Sorry, you go first, Max. You have a good point.
So, one thing I will say that Brody has said multiple times now, if you were to actually practice once in a while with your Zelda, you would become... the most terrifying Zelda in the whole group, and you w- and if you do, you will be giving me a run for my money in the bracket there.
Oh mate, I have been practicing.
Don't and worry. I mean, well, let me put it this way, boys. You guys are tied in terms of bracket count right now for all of our friend group tournaments. 13-13. That is such an impressive number to me, because you are the only people in this whole friend group who genuinely have the skill to stay close to each other.
Dude, literally, if I, like, literally, when Brody
it's
brought
like
that...
It's like Goku and Vegeta.
Literally, when Brody brought that, I was like, hey, is it... Like, we were in a call. I think we were playing Apex, funny enough. He's like, hey, guys, you know what's funny? You guys have the same, like, record. Like, you guys are both 26 rounds, like, 26 games, and you have both 13-13. And we were flabbergasted at that idea.
It's honestly really impressive, because it shows that you guys both have your own waves of talent, like, flow through you guys. Like, you guys have your moments where Max might win hardcore for, like, a year straight, and then Dawson will bounce back just as fucking hard. And
then just knock me out like that.
Yeah. So,
like...
Oh, it's just so cool, because it's like, this is the last time that you guys are going to get to straight-up competitive tournament battle of everything put down the line. The winner has bragging rights for lifetime, basically. It's kind of fun.
Do you know what would be funny? If we just go to a tournament and then
the only way for it to be beat is if me and Dawson were to sign up for the tournament and we got faced against each other.
And then somehow, like, let's say Max wins and I just beat him, and we're like, well, I guess it's even again.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you guys do end up doing that, then we can have a thug match where loser takes off their shirt on stream or something like that.
Oh,
yeah,
well, yeah. Like, add some fun to it. There, a little flair to the gameplay.
Like, there may be a chance where years later, I'll see a Smash tournament pop up and be like, you know what? Let's do it. Let's contact the boys and see how they're doing.
I want to take you guys to Toronto and take you to Gommel so bad. I want to take you guys to a really big tournament. If Battle of BC 7 is like late May to early June sometime next year, book me up, because I won't be in classes if I can actually go this time. I'd be hyped for that.
Like, dude, like when I went to Battle BC 5, I was like, I played a couple rounds against people, mm-hmm. and I took rounds off. Like, I took a whole game off people.
Yeah.
Too.
Which is awesome.
And, like I was doing fine, too. And made me think, I was like, I wish I entered in the tournament. Because I was like, I want to see how far I went.
Wow. I don't even think I've ever heard you actually say that. That's, like, that's kind of cool.
Well, because, like, again, I was like, I took games off of people. Right. I was doing good.
Right. But that's also here.
Like, and, like, some of it was with Incineroar, and some of it was with Zelda.
So that's two whole characters where you can genuinely have results with.
Oh, I know. That's why I don't ditch Incineroar and Zelda.
Good. That's good.
Yeah. So I'm going to add one more thing before we go on to the next topic here.
Yes, yes.
Indeed.
So one thing I forgot to say when I was speaking there. So one of my dreams is to end up going to Evo or something like that and making it up there.
Yeah.
But I don't think I could make it up there in Smash. Because from the last tournament we watched,
we watched Genesis 10 over at Sweatslayer's house, and it was phenomenal. Like, that was probably one of the most hyped tournaments I've seen in so long. We got to see some good Rob gameplay, and like there was some really good top tiers in the meta mm-hmm. that were just like vibrant. We saw some Corrin, and oh, it was so good, very good tournament.
Like what I want to do, like my dream for Smash is like. Potentially make competitive look funny, like in a weird way.
I'm sure, considering your humor, I think you could easily do that with Zelda and Sinnoh. It just seems
easy.
Like that's why I like those characters, because you could do some funny shit. But yeah.
I have to say, one of the funniest kills you can get is grabbing someone when they're at 100% up throwing, then just up being on them.
Oh no! This is what
Zelda
this,
or
no. This
Zelda.
Is
Zelda.
Oh, okay.
No, I got a way funnier thing. How about you freaking stage spike someone with Incineroar's, like, grab move, and just when he throws them up and he gets stage spiked, I don't know if that works or not, but I hope that's I
it
hope
depends
it does.
On the depends on the slants of the ledge and how far underneath you can get. But if someone's weird enough to go underneath the stage of like Smashville or something like that, so you can side with them with a sewer, I think they deserve to miss that tick.
dude, if I get that off, it's gonna be like the funniest shit ever.
I agree.
Yeah. So I say we move on to our next topic here, yeah, which I believe is topic 3.
Yep. Final Fragments, yeah. Last tournament of our legacy. So, I mean, we've been talking about tournaments for the last little while anyways, but...
We haven't.
This is...
But, yeah, we kind of went into it, but this will be our
a good
final
tangent.
Smash tournament.
Yes, like, it definitely will.
And like cool. I said, out of the group, I will be one of the people that will be putting the controller down for good.
It's... Sad.
Hours.
Oh, fuck. Can make me feel shit, dude. Like...
That is one of the biggest, biggest part of my life.
Yeah,
that like, I will be like putting down.
I know, I feel that. And we have five whole tournaments we're running this day. Like we're running Smash Ultimate Singles. We got the nostalgia bracket for Smash 4. We're bringing it back. We're just gonna give everyone a little bump of love and just say, hey, let's go feel what it's like the perfect pivot again. And then we got doubles. And we have a casual bracket, which is going to be one of the other fun ones. And then anybody who doesn't make top 8 is going to be signed into an amateur bracket. So it's technically only 4 tournaments, but we also have another surprise tournament. And Max actually is the one who's going to be setting this one up. So you can actually talk about this one. I'll give you a quick moment to talk about this because it's going to be it's going to be a side event. I don't even know if it's going to hit streams, but maybe grand finals.
He's excited. Yeah. He's excited.
Yeah. So for a side event, me and Ben kind of been talking back and forth here. And we decided it would be fun to have a Mario Kart on the side there. But
I thought you were gonna talk about the Skylanders. Oh shit!
Don't worry. That's next. That's next.
We have two side events. Oh, let's go.
Oh yeah. So we going back to one of the original Mario Karts first of all. Double Dash.
Yes, I love. Dude, never, Double Dash is gonna be great.
Never played it.
Double Dash is one of the hardest. Double Dash is one of the hardest, in my opinion, one of the hardest Mario Karts out there.
All right, hear me out. You and Ben can't be on the same team, though, right? Like, you two are too good.
We're making that a rule.
Okay, thank God.
If me and Ben go on the same team, we will end up perfect drifting, perfect boosting. It'd just be unfair.
Ben will practice the speedrun tactics, unironically. For anybody who doesn't know the context, Ben is our third best Smash player in our group.
The one that's going to be the best both side events would be, as you mentioned, the Skylanders one. Recently, I went back to my parents' place and got every single one of my Skylanders.
You have like 100. You have so many. I've seen Amiibo collections that are significantly smaller.
I also have 100 Skylanders that I can bring.
Yeah, totally.
He does. He has a bookshelf.
They're literally chilling on my bed. Like on top of my bed.
Yeah.
I have a Bowser's.
I did show Dawson the photo, if that's what you're grabbing.
Yeah, okay. I showed him.
He was like,
I have the same amount of you guys. I have also a Bowser Skylander on top of that.
Yeah, and it turns into an amiibo. Because that's just
it's fucking. It's sick, dude.
Sam Max was good.
Yeah, Max, I will. Do you want me to send you a picture of it?
Later on. But back to it.
Yeah. We have content, guys. We have so much content to go through this day. Like April 24th is gonna be, it's gonna be a sick day. So like, make sure you guys check it out when it hits my stream. It's gonna be on Twitch.tv/Chronicos. For anybody who's watching like through the podcast and not actually like on my YouTube channel or wherever else I decide to post this, that's gonna be at CHRONIK0S, not my O, because someone else took the tag before I could make it on Twitch. You little rat.
Yeah. Fuck that guy.
Anyways, sure they're a respectable person, but let's move on a little bit more because I feel like we're really close to finishing up with this topic as well. So, last tournament of our legacy. We've got like so much that we have planned as well for this. I typically run a little thing called Who Wants to Be a Cringeneer. I started that at the Winter Solstice event. People have really enjoyed it. Fun little prizes that people get. Like we did the Cringe Crew mouse pads for that one. They were great. I still have mine. It's like, it's in perfect condition. I use it every single day. Not a single color has left.
I still have mine.
So
still mine.
They're fantastic. But I'm running round two this time, and I have so many bangers I'm bringing out. I'm going to be hitting home on every single number I can find. If it's
There's just one specific question that I can't answer because I can't remember, but it's one that we decided that we were going to add. That was something very specific.
Oh, like niche ones? Oh, there's going to be a bunch of niche ones. I'm going to have some stuff like who was the first people that met in like high school for like stuff like that. Like really like we're going into like when people met each other. Who like who's got this and this such lifestyle right now? And then it's going to be like I'm going to hit home with these. I have video ideas that I've currently got in the making. Heck, we're doing the podcast right now. I still have to make the trailer that goes with this podcast, and that's going to be on my Twitter, on my YouTube, on... I'm not going to stream it on Twitch, obviously, but maybe that'll be one that'll...
Disappointing.
I know. But I have really good ideas for this, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it. It's still in the down low, but this is one of the first tournaments where I'm like, I just want people to see what we're made of. I just want people to really see and get that vibe that, like, we're just one of those friend groups where, like, you could throw the whole world at us, and we're just going to enjoy life.
Well, I feel like that's so much of us. There is one other thing that Dawson doesn't know, but me and you know. I messaged you a bit ago about it.
Okay. Mm. Trying to remember. Like, I'm trying to remember off the top of my head.
Is this something I can know?
Yeah, you know, well, I'll let him know.
I mean, I kind of want to know now.
So, about 2 weeks or a week ago or something like that, I was just scrolling through YouTube and I came across an amazing song.
Oh, yes. Okay, I know. I remember exactly what you're talking about. Yeah. Let's just say, like, we're gonna have some really Canadian style breakfast when we have the tournament start up. That's the perfect way to explain.
Oh yeah, this is gonna be so with it.
Dude, we're gonna be so Alberta about this tournament. It's gonna be nuts. Like,
are we having poutines and bacon and eggs?
You think they might have Canadian?
That's kind of.
But you're not thinking Canadian enough.
Yeah.
What's something that the States doesn't have, but we do?
We invented poutine, but they still have poutine.
Damn it!
Okay, I'm just gonna cut to the chase. Just a little bit of Tim Hortons, my dude.
Oh, let's go!
Literally, we're popping off over, like, we're popping off over eggs and bacon. Let's go.
Dooms!
Oh man, yeah, we have a good idea for that, and I think you guys are really gonna enjoy it. We won't spoil it.
Definitely.
Because I think that even the people watching the podcast are like, okay, something Tim Hortons related, that sounds cool. So, you guys are gonna enjoy what we're cooking. Me and Max have a fantastic idea, and it's gonna be pretty cool. We'll be able to talk more about it in the future. I think I don't know if it'll be like a next podcast type of deal, but it's gonna be pretty nice. Okay, now let's move on to topic four, because I feel like that's gonna be a really important one. Biggest names on who to look out for in this tournament. We got 17 players, so let's talk about a couple of those players and how good they are. I think that's a fair way to start this up. So, I guess I'll start with one player. We'll keep rotating around, and you guys can each talk about one individual player, and we'll just comment on what each other says. I'm going to start with Aaron, I think. I'm going to start with Aaron. He's ranked number four in our friend group in terms of skill. So, literally one placement above Max. He's won the Winter Solstice event, which was one that me and Zach did not participate in competing in. And he took his first upset over Ben, and that was really impressive for him. He's the second Toon Link player in the group, and he's probably played Toon Link for about as long as I have. So, this friend group is one of those ones where it's like, if you really don't like fighting Toon Link, I'm sorry for your loss, because you will fight one on either side of the bracket. But, yeah.
Oh, no.
It's he does have a lot of very good situational awareness with Toon Link. He's very good at understanding. I don't want to call him the For Glory player of the friend group, but he does a lot of the Smash 4 competitive habits where it was like, oh, roll when you dodge something, or like, sorry, roll when you whiff a punish, or doing a back throw at the ledge with Toon Link, and like things you would expect from like, not like an early on player, but like someone who's like intermediate and trying to break out of that cycle. He's still a good player though. Like he has his tempo, and he sticks to his tempo. So I honestly think that Aaron is one of the scarier players to look out for, because if he's pressing the right buttons that day and they connect, he probably has, like, the biggest and most rudest awakenings for a lot of players who are trying to get into that top four and try to get an upset. He's definitely one of those players who can do that. So that is the person that I would bring up for in names to look out for. So I guess we'll go on to Max now and we'll see what he says.
Well, for me, one of the names I would look out for would be Ben, because he plays the weirdest play style I've ever seen.
It is straight up weird.
You can't lock on what he's going to do next. And he goes for some of the weirdest stuff I've ever seen, too.
We did a VOD review of his gameplay.
Yeah, we literally did. all of us were like, what the frick is he doing?
He sat underneath a platform with Donkey Kong and up-tilted 5 times in a row and did not move.
and somehow that works. It's really funny. It just works.
Yeah,
but other than that, but Ben, when he does actually want to play, that's when he becomes really scary.
I agree.
Really scary.
He's a top player in our group for a reason. He understands, he understands, like, really good advantage, and then, like, he just kind of struggles with neutral, I think, and that's kind of where he, like, his weirdness kind of takes over, and he just weirds until he can advantage.
Yeah, he wears that. He's like, finally, I'm an advantage. Yeah.
He's like, I got you, boy.
Yeah. Dawson, give us a player from our
group. All right. So I'm going to mention a newcomer, actually. He's never been to a tournament.
Okay.
I want to say Adam, honestly.
Oh, I guess.
Because honestly, a lot of our friend group doesn't know what the heck he does.
That's true. So hey, Adam is definitely top six. Absolutely, like, guaranteed. He's so good.
Like, from when I fought him, he, like, this is a long time. I think this is, like, a year ago. But, like, he was good. Like, I was able to do stuff, but he kind of destroyed me. And for someone who's, like, from what I've heard from Brody, he's able to, he's on par from what Brody can do. And if that's good, then holy shit.
So, let me put into retrospect here. Adam has not been to a single one of our friend group tournaments, but he's probably been the one who's known my path in the Smash Bros. Since the very beginning. He was there for when I won the first tournament I went to. He was there for so many events, and he plays so many good characters. He plays, like, Ness, and Yoshi, and Rob, and Wii Fit Trainer, and he's got a Mario. His Mario's his character he cooks with now. But the reason that he's so good is because he perfectly counteracts my advantage state, and that works amazingly in this game. Like,
oh yeah,
he's one of those players where I will try to get my funny stuff in advantage, and because he knows me so well, he translates that into his disadvantage gameplay, and I almost never get anything extended off. That combined with the fact that he does understand what to go for when in terms of gameplay, and he's just really good at the game. Like, he just needs to practice a little bit, because he typically only practiced with his little brother Ethan, who's also coming to the event, by the way. And honestly, like, really scary player. So
yeah, that's why I thought I should bring him up, because I don't think we're gonna. But
weren't going to, it was gonna be my turn, and I was gonna say.
No, I know. That's what I was like. I'm gonna get it, my guy. Yeah.
No, you definitely beat me to the punch. So good stuff, because, like, Adam is definitely one to look out for. If he's currently seeded to fight Aaron in bracket, so I don't know who's gonna win. Unironically, I think that's an even matchup. Yeah. I mean, you guys haven't played against him much, so let me put it this way.
I fought him for one day. And that
you
was
guys,
it.
You guys fought him one day in the apartment, and that was kind of all you've had for real experience. I don't know if he's better than Zach. I do think that he might be on par with Ben, but I've seeded him a little bit lower because I feel like it depends on his practice prior to the event, and he's coming down. He's flying down all the way from BC to come and be in this last event with us, which is super sweet of him. And I'm honestly really happy to say that, like, this is literally my childhood best friend is coming out to participate in this tournament, so it's really cool. But he's good. He's really good at the game. So if he's on stream, which I will probably ensure happens, look out for his saucy spikes, because he really likes the spikes. Okay.
Got it.
Yeah, I guess I kind of took over your turn there, Dawson.
Yeah, you Adam, son of a gun.
So I'll give you another turn. Let's all right. have you talk about all another right. top player.
So I will actually talk about, like, the Sweat Slayer. We already went into a little bit of detail on him. He has a great roster of characters already. He is picking up Steve, and he has a Byleth currently in the back. And from my knowledge, he has also a Peach just sitting there. Just
and a Zero
really...
Suit Samus.
Oh, that. Oh, yeah, he does have play Samus.
And Cloud. He has a good, but, like, a good roster.
From what I've known of Zach, he's, like, for the longest time, he's played Smash Ultimate. He's played on the dumbest freaking controller, which is the freaking, which is the box. And literally, I tried one game with it. I said, no.
For retrospect, for anybody in the podcast, three of his left fingers will do the movement options, but up or jump on his stick is actually his right pinky. So take your three middlemost fingers on your left hand, and then take your pinky on your right hand. That is your movement options with the character. Oh, that's yeah. how he. That's how, like, he's forced to play. It's gross. It's really gross.
Like literally, he also played, like, he also had a separate configuration just for Peach, by the way.
Yep.
Flow just cancels. For Peach. And he's easily our second best player.
Yeah.
In our really friend strong. Group, like he has gotten really far in tournaments. He has had some also weird, like, he gets freaking, like, eliminated, but then he has, like, a freaking, like, an amazing, like, freaking like losers bracket.
Yeah, he's second in the group for a reason. He proved that he's definitely stronger than Ben.
He has proved it time and time again that he is our second best player.
Mm-hmm.
For many reasons.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you there. Okay, topic five, because we've kind of talked about a lot of the top players. So let's go into most hype matches we're looking forward to in this tournament. And I'm going to start this one with Max, because I feel like, Max, I feel like you have some other people that you might think are some good matchups that you want to see. Doesn't matter if they are or aren't playing in bracket. You can say, like, some ones that you would
with
be
that
hyped
link
to see.
You sent. Can I see the matches?
Oh,
or
actually,
no?
I have another link. So while we're talking about that one, I'll show you the current roster in terms of the
yeah. Tournament. If I can get a look at what the matches are, then I can kind of be like, ooh, okay.
I gotcha.
I mean, Max, if you don't mind me sabotaging your turn, I already know one that's our most hyped up.
Hey, if you already have one in mind, you go right ahead, bud.
So literally, it's ours. It's literally gonna be ours matchup.
Of course. Well, obviously.
It is literally
that
ours.
That one was plain.
Yeah, but like we better get it out of the way.
It's literally the best opinion. Tiebreaker in our friend group. It's like it's gonna be like if the viewership does not skyrocket, I will be upset.
like the reason why we already went in full detail about this earlier on in the podcast, but again, we're just amazed that we from all the matches we've done, it is dead on even. And in fact,
like I said earlier, it's very Goku and Vegeta like. one surpasses the other person in skill, and aka Vegeta goes, oh hell nah, and again gets up to that level.
oh yeah. I hear you. Like, again, that's why I just thought we better get that out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
So
yeah, the link's in the chat now for you guys, so you guys are good to see it.
All right, perfect.
Do take any of the projected games or like games that are like like anything that even if it isn't actually like player versus player that we can see yet, take it and turn it into retrospective. I want to hear if you guys have any people you want to see battle each other. Cause like we have a couple interesting ones. We have like I said, Adam versus Aaron, Basement Dweller, is going to be happening for top 12 of the bracket. And that's going to be like winner goes on to fight me. That's well, I shouldn't say to fight me, but if I make it as far in bracket, then that is probably what's going to happen. We also have...
Bro, he just gets eliminated.
I could. You never know. Like, if someone just plays really good, I could just lose. It hasn't happened yet in any of our friend group tournaments. But I wouldn't be surprised if, like, this could be the tournament where, like, someone, like, finally gets a win on me. Like a full best of three or best of five win in bracket. Zach is so close. Like, I honestly, like, if Zach plays Steve to the best of his ability that day, I could be walking home with second. And I would not be upset about that at all, because he's been playing so good. Anyways, sorry, Max, your turn.
So, as soon as I opened up the link and went to the matches, one match caught my eye right away.
Okay.
And it would be Expanded Dong versus Sybil Z.
Oh, okay. So we got Ben versus the second Zach in the friend group. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, my Zach.
Yeah. I have him
in the
bracket.
From
what I've heard and from what I've seen, his Terry is kind of spicy.
Oh yeah. No, I can confirm.
And if he knows that one Terry combo that you showed me, I say it's over for Ben.
I mean, yeah, I don't
Unless
know. I feel
Ben
like
plays a certain character.
Unironically, I feel like you definitely have a better shot with your Terry though, because it depends on how busy Silby gets before the bracket.
Yeah,
but I do agree. If Silby like hardcore practice from now till the tournament, it's definitely possible for someone to beat one of our top three members just by practicing hard.
Like, also to let you know, he also plays Sheik.
Oh, it's true. But Sheik kind of gets dumpstered by Ben. Ben has a really good character spread.
Oh yeah.
Okay, Dawson, your turn. You choose a matchup.
Okay. You know what? Just because I'm curious on how this goes, I'm gonna say Havoc Shade and the Sweat Slayer.
Okay. All right. So here's my prediction for this.
Like,
Zach's gonna win because he's gonna play Steve.
Yeah, like Zach's gonna win, but like, what is the match gonna look like?
So this
like,
is what it's gonna be. This is going to be our Akala versus Sonics, which is quite literally translated to, we're going to watch Zach play Steve versus Darien Sonic, and that is how that match is going to go. We are literally watching the top two characters in the tier list play for top, basically it says top 24 on the winner's round two.
Again, I'm just curious, like, what is the match going to look like?
I think that Zach wins 2-0 or 2-1.
Yeah. But, like, I'm curious, like, how well will Darien fight against Zach?
Well,
like, again,
if Zach does go Steve... Oh, it's a wash.
It's gonna take one simple block build-up and have extend.
Oh, yeah, no, that is possible, yes. It is clearly possible.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be pretty highly in Zach's favor to win this match. I mean, that's the reason it's a round one to begin with, but...
Indeed.
But I mean, I think that's gonna be a hype match for sure, because even though they play characters that are considered lame, we're not at a good enough level in our friend group where we stop approaching and we actually like start like going for cheesy shit. We actually like we just want to play the video game and enjoy it, even if it's tournament. So we actually just go in anyways. So like Zach's gonna wall him, and then like Darien's gonna be like, well, fuck, I can't dash attack. I see.
Yeah.
All right.
Like for just a little bit off topic here, one thing that you just said there, there's times where we've been injured, but we still gone to Smash tournaments. AKA me.
Night before
Smash Horizon 2, I'm at work and I cut my thumb down to the bone.
It was so sad.
And I actually had to pause mid-game. I think it was against Zach to re-bandage because it reopened.
That sucks.
And started bleeding really bad. I had no choice but to take the stock for that. Zach said, you don't have to. I was like, it's tournament rolls. I gotta. So I took the stock.
That's right. You did do that. You were a man. Holy shit.
He was.
The pain, though. I don't know how I pushed through it though. That sucked.
With a thumb too. Ugh. Thumb injuries when playing Smash actually are like the worst ones. Like,
especially when it's your movement thumb.
Yeah.
You've never done it. Never done it. Can't vouch for that.
I'd be claw grip or index fingering like the whole time. Like I just couldn't. I'd be so gross. All right, now here's mine. Here's one of the matches I think is gonna be really hype, and you guys are gonna be really surprised about this. But we're also kind of looking at the same round of matches here. And these are both players that we have not talked about at all today. So, this one is projected to be Dylan favored for the win, I think. But it's going to be Dylan versus Chase, Kuma Bear versus Prophet of Mountain Dew. This match, I think, is going to be very specific because Chase came in and almost beat Tristan on his first tournament in Winter Solstice. He went 3-2 against his Palutena. And that's how close he brought it. That was probably like peak Chase gameplay that we had, and it was a really hype stream match because Chase took the first game. He had a Pikachu in the back. He's got Ice Climbers as well. He plays really like really out of their characters where like he just hits hard. But
Dylan also plays Ganon, which can kill in a matter of 3 moves.
It's going to literally come down to, does Dylan's experience through the game overall beat out Chase in terms of gameplay and win him the set? Or does Chase, now that he's got himself a Switch, from what I've heard, practice really hard and just learn Pyromithra Ganon and just take that win? Because if he does, it'll be... we would see Chase potentially outplacing Havoc in terms of results on this bracket, which would be wild.
Yeah, that's fair.
Damn.
I think Dylan makes a sick loser's run, though. He's one of those people where, like, yeah, he's seeded low, but he's seeded low because the seeding in terms of bracket is based on how many events you've actually shown up to in terms of also results, so it's both combined. So,
yeah.
Like, if Max showed up and he had, like, a higher win rate against Ben, like, he'd probably be number 3. Like, that would just be how it would be.
So, just in theory, let's say somehow me and Aaron either meet up at semifinals or...
like, you're thinking, like, winners, like, losers top 4? Let's say losers top
4? Yeah, losers top 4 or winners top 6.
Yep.
If I were to knock Aaron out completely, would that place me over him?
You'd be, well, guaranteed in bracket, yes. And also, in terms, because this is the final tournament, I feel like you'd be ranked higher as the overall player because he loses to Ben consistently. You have a relatively even matchup against Ben where he's like 8-2, I think, or 8-3. So he has a lot more losses on his plate as well because he's played Ben a lot more. If you show up, you beat, let's just say by some chance, let's say your bracket is, because I'm looking at the thing right now, let's say you beat Dawson, you go up, you fight Ben, you beat Ben, you lose to Zach, and that puts you down in position 30, which puts you in loser's top 6. Let's say Aaron comes in from roughly the same spot on the opposite side of bracket, and you guys play for loser's top 4. That would guarantee you 3rd place in the tournament, and he would lose in 4th, right? So you would have higher results, which would give you more points towards your win. And he would have lost to a person that would be considered an upset. And you would have also had huge wins on Ben and Dawson. So, quite frankly, I think you probably would outplace him. I don't know about overall for, like, lifetime, because he did win Winter Solstice.
Yeah.
But, like, I mean, it's definitely possible that, like, you could, for theoretically, like, the last tournament, be outranking him in terms of results.
Okay, yeah.
Especially if he lost, if he loses to, like his, if he gets 2-0'd, he could absolutely, like, plummet in ranking. Like, that could just happen.
Oh, wow. Yeah. My goal is to at least make it to winner semifinals.
Winner semis? All right. I think that's a really good placement. Like, that's super doable for you.
Mm-hmm. Because I'll have to get through Dawson, then either Ben or Silly Z. Then when I get there, most likely, Sweat Slayer, just because
I think
of his matches
Zach.
He has. Yeah. So, very high chance of Zach being there. Mm-hmm. And if he goes Steve, well, then I have to find out very quickly how do I get around this Steve?
Practice makes perfect. So we'll find answers
indeed,
for you.
Indeed.
Okay.
Yes.
I think, like, we've looked at some of the matches from, like, the first couple rounds. Now, let's do one, like, match where it's, like, it's not currently happening on the list, but, like, we'll do one rotation more each where it's, like, what would you want to see for, like, another matchup? Like, which two players? It could be you versus someone else. It could be two other players. It could be just another
one matchup that I would love to happen in this tournament.
Yeah.
Would be me against Aaron.
I agree. I think it's got to happen.
Because, like me and Dawson, me and Aaron are also very on skill level. At times, he does surpass me, but I always catch back up to him.
Yep.
And our matches, I don't know if you see me and Aaron when we're playing against each other, but we're like...
You guys literally move around all the time when you play. It's so hype. You have the energy.
Yeah.
No, I definitely think you're right
with
on
your
that.
Character.
I definitely
but
think
yeah,
you're right
that's,
on that.
That's a matchup I really want to do. All right,
Dawson, your turn then.
I want to see Expand Dong and why not Havoc Shade? Why not?
You want to see Ben versus Havoc? All right.
Yeah. Why? I think it could be a very fun match.
We're gonna watch Sonic Dittos.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
They did that last time. Last time they played, they did Sonic Dittos on Bridge of Elden, and Havoc won that game. It was kind of funny. Yeah, he just backed through him. He backed through him, he backed through him off the side.
Yeah, see, it was. I thought it was funny. Okay, last time they did it. So
Ben won the set, though, mind you. Ben won the set, but still.
Yeah. Ben won the set, but I want to see a round two of that. Come on, let's get another.
All right,
let's get another.
All right, Brody, what matchup would you want to see?
I have two. I'm gonna put back to back because I want to get both brothers involved in this. I want to see, Ethan, aka he's Graham on this list for you guys. That's Adam's little brother.
All right.
I want to see him play Dylan. I think that would be really hype, and the reason is because they would be playing Cloud, Mario, and Ganon versus Ganondorf and whatever else Dylan wants to play. Like, he might play Hero.
Dylan
right?
has been.
And Rob,
I would say here. There's one more character that he's been popping off.
Oh, Sephiroth. What the heck? Why am I miss Sephiroth? Yeah.
Sephiroth. Yeah.
So,
Dylan has
Cloud Sephiroth versus Sephiroth? Ganon Dittos? That sounds hype as hell. And they would literally deliver. Mm-hmm. So, that's the first one. The other one is going to be in winner's quarterfinals of top 12, at least projected wise for me. It's going to be Aaron versus Adam, because I don't know
Aaron versus Adam.
I don't know anything that's going to happen with this set, but it's going to be on stream. I will take priority. Whoever's on stream will get booted. It could be me. I will go to loser's bracket just to watch this set.
I'm just casually just like freaking Tio, like what spectating it and being like, all right guys, so. And then bro's like, get the freak out of here.
Everybody get off my setup.
Like, that's literally what's going to happen.
We need to have the double A's play. But I definitely think that those would be really fun sets. So now we've kind of like gone over a lot of the fun matches and things like that. I think we're finally into the last, like,
our last topic. Then.
Last topic. So final thoughts.
Do you want to go first on this one there, Brody?
I think we let Dawson go first.
Oh.
Yeah. Dawson, what are your final thoughts of this being
last Smash tournament in our friend group? Like last
ever to be streamed.
Oh.
I think
a long time.
So for tournaments, I think we're going to do one eventually. Are we going to stream it? No. It's not going to happen. No,
I'm not moving my 60-pound tower ever again.
literally, I think the only way we would stream a tournament is Pokemon. Like, that is literally it. Mm-hmm. Is because
if we were to get another game, because there are so many games that we all own.
I think there's other games we end up playing, but I think that in terms of Smash Bros, we've kind of hit our stride.
Yeah, we've hit our limit.
Like Kiara, for example, she's done. She's so done, dude.
She's not want to play Bowser Jr. ever again.
No, she loves Bowser Jr.
True, but still.
But the likelihood of us like playing the game again and doing a tournament, maybe just for funsies. That's literally it. We're just for nostalgia reasons. We're like, why don't we do another tournament? Mm-hmm. Why not? And unfortunately, the likelihood of us getting together like this again is severely unlikely. Because, this is our last...
Just all the planning it takes to do something like this.
I've done... There's been so many times where I'm like, guys, we need this date. Everyone get the heck off work. We need to hang out. We need to be friends, guys. We need to hang out and be friends.
Literally, when me and Brody were discussing like tournament stuff, like we were low key frustrated on a bunch of just to set up the damn fucking tournament.
That's true. We were
okay.
It's not easy.
How do we do this? And then like setting up brackets and making sure that it's fun for everyone is very frustrating. But like that's the type of sacrifices you have to make to make sure that like everyone's happy while they're there. Because you don't want to make people let's say Max just breaks in, like this is his final one, but he ends up breaking his freaking GC again. We don't want that. We want him to enjoy himself.
Mm-hmm. Enjoy using his GameCube controller next time he plays Mario Kart Double Dash.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely.
He's going to end up using my GC just for that.
Yeah. Max, you want me to go first or do you want to go first? I feel like
I'll go last.
You'll go last?
You
okay.
Go up.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm sitting up in my chair because I feel like
I'll
I have some fun
a
things
bit
to say.
Deep.
Yeah. I get you. I feel like mine's getting there too. Like I've been feeling it for the last like 20 minutes about like, man.
Not gonna lie. The first time I started talking about me putting
I kind of noticed it in
the
your voice
tears.
A little bit. Yeah. I know. It's tough. It's hard. Like this has been, like we've said, 8 years of our lives that we've put into so much fun, so much excitement. It really is one of those things where just it's a wonderful, amazing miracle that our friend group is as strong as it is over a Nintendo fighting game. It's really cute to kind of just be able to put that into perspective that we just have this friendship and like this love over what we've been doing for so long. And it's not just that we have like these casual players, but these competitive players and all like these people that just show up just because I happen to message in Discord, hey guys, let's get November 15th off, let's go have a fun day and just play Smash. And it's the only time where our friend group says yes. It kind of hurts sometimes because it's sad to not be able to just say, hey guys, let's go, let's all take off work and go mini golfing, let's all go get a dinner somewhere.
Mini golfing's not happening.
We really don't do anything like that, and it's kind of sad that like it takes Smash Bros to be the thing that really pushes. But
I definitely agree with you on that.
I think that this is our chance though, because I think once this last wheelbarrow of enjoyment is like burnt over the fire of our past enjoyments and whatnot, we're gonna move on and we're gonna adult and get into a really impressive like part of our lives where we all start doing adult things. People are gonna start getting their jobs. Heck, Tristan wants to get into truck work. We might not see him again after that, but that's the type of lifestyle that a lot of these people are gonna have. Like, we're growing up. We're truly becoming great people with our lives, and we're glad we get to share this last tournament with you guys. So, from the bottom of my heart and from me, Dawson, Max, and everybody, we thank you guys so much for even just listening to the podcast, like just watching the stream when it happens. Like, you guys make this happen. Like, we wouldn't have been here if Zach didn't happen to make some troll trailers and play some video games with us in a basement. We wouldn't have like the viewership, and we wouldn't have a lot of the things that we look up to nowadays. And so to me, like this tournament hits me hard because it's life, it's love, it's everything in between. And I feel like I'll probably cry on the day of the tournament. Like when I start handing out personalized gifts and you guys see some of the things I've been working on in the background, you guys are going to realize how much this meant to me. And I really hope that like I deliver my message of how much this is to you guys. Cause like, I mean, we're doing a freaking podcast. We've never done this in our lives, but you guys really are something special to me. So even to like both of you right now, like, thank you guys so much for making this happen. Like, it's
no
just
problem.
It's so nice to have this. So, I'm going to move it on to Max before I start crying. Cause
don't cry
feels.
Like a bitch.
Oh yeah, dude.
Hey, screw you. If I cry, I'm crying, alright?
I understand. Here. This is the world.
No, don't do it. Don't cry, Max. You're gonna make me cry.
Fist bump in the fist bumping you one more time.
Like I said earlier in the podcast here, I will officially be putting it down.
Yeah.
It's hitting you, man.
It is, bro. Because it's such a big part of my life.
It is.
Ugh. Man, you're going to make me cry. Don't do this, man.
Fuck. what did we do to ourselves? This video game is so mean to us.
You're giving us emotions!
And like, just from this one game, and over the 8 years, we've had so many ups and downs, fights, and we always somehow come back together. It's just going to be hard to let go.
I know.
Indeed. Indeed, man.
I agree with you.
It's gonna be really hard to let go.
I know. I definitely share that with you.
But with letting it go, it's gonna open up a huge horizon for us. Mm-hmm. Like, some of us are are going to split off on their own, start doing their own things.
Right.
While some of us will be still kind of be in there, but doing off their own things, still trying to get friends together. Make sure the friend group is still the friend group.
Right. We're going to have that bond. It's going to keep us strong.
Yeah. Like heck, I'm moving from my town to a totally different one.
Which is, so, like, that's incredible. Like, that's such a huge step. And literally because we play a Nintendo fighting game.
Yeah.
Yeah, this game has accomplished a lot of stuff for us.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
It's like, if it wasn't for Smash, I probably would have never entered into that Fighter Z tournament.
Right? I mean, yeah. Fuck, how far would our friendship have gone if we didn't play this video game together?
Honestly, if it wasn't for Smash, I would have never walked into that gaming club room.
Right?
Like, low key, when I heard you guys were playing, like, Smash Brothers, I was like, I'm interested. And I would have never met Brody.
Right.
Like that's crazy to think about. I would have never gotten, like, I already knew Max. But I would never have gotten to know him as good as I did because I walked into that room.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I still remember my first thing that Max told me, don't fight Brody. You know what I freaking did? I fought Brody.
In Smash, mind you, not in real life.
Yeah. I've
never thrown a fist with any of these people in my life, and I never
like
will.
Literally, I said, okay. So what does he look like? And Max points directly at him. And I walk up to him. I was like, "Do you want to play a game of Smash?"
And then you learned very quickly why I said that.
Yeah, and you know what? I didn't care. I had fun.
Yeah, it's because I think in my perspective of like, if I never had Smash, I still would have known Adam 100%. We were neighbors. We played Pokemon together. That's what really brought us together. I would have known Zach because we were in the same class together, and that's what made us talk, was we actually were working on videos. But, like, I think at the very most, me and Dylan would have talked about Legend of Zelda, and that, like, I don't know how much farther our friendship would have gone initially at that point, but, like, he knew Zach, so I think the three of us would have still known each other, but, like, I don't know if I would have known Max, because we didn't know each other until robotics class. And,
yeah, robotics class, and then I just walked up to you, Dylan, like, hey, you need a third?
And literally it was, we talked and we conversed, but we didn't really, like, hang out until Smash, until we explained that the game club was going to happen. And then that was the opening avenue for everything. So, like, if Smash Bros. Didn't happen, where the heck does that go? Like, I wouldn't have known Max. We wouldn't have done Pokemon Go, like down, like, after, like downtown, swimming at the Leisure Center after, like, every Sunday. Oh, yeah.
The funny thing, Brody, I think I still would have known you, to be fair. Because it's maybe. Because of Sydney. Literally because of Sydney.
Well, I knew Sydney because she went to school with me. But, like, I don't know if that connection would have transferred over. Like it would have been like, well, what do we know?
I guess true,
I mean, yeah. I sure as hell hope we do. Because, like, I hope in every timeline I know you guys. Because you guys literally make every day so amazing for me. So...
Indeed, yeah. Man. I hope in some way we always meet up and end up being friends.
I know. Oh, listen to this deep convo we're having over Smash Bros, guys.
guys, you want to play Smash later on?
Yeah. You have online?
No!
Okay. All right. Does anybody else want to say anything before I do a final closing statement?
Well, no,
I've got everything other than... Thank you guys all so much for watching. We hope you guys continue watching.
Mm-hmm.
And see you in the next one, really.
Right. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. Max, you totally stole his outro.
No, it's fine. You can steal the outro. He can have it as the whole outro. I'm just going to say, like, make sure you guys check out the stream, please. April 24th. I will be tweeting about it on my Twitter, at BrodyOB. I will have... if you guys are in, like, a lot of, like, the Alberta-related eSport Association discords and whatnot, I will be promoting it there. Our friend group is going to probably try and promote it because it's going to be really important to a lot of us to kind of just close off on this amazing good note and really spread the love one last time. So, once again, just in case, like, you guys don't want to have to go back through the VOD to, like, look back and see where this is all happening. youtube.com/chronikos, chronikos. That's the easiest place you can find me. I have links to everything else on there, and in all of my videos, it should be pretty clear. But if you want to check out my Twitch, leave a follow there. You can check that out at twitch.tv/chronikos, chronikos, and that'll be the last thing that I think we have for this podcast, guys. Thank you all so much, and as Max said, we hope you enjoy.
Indeed.
Thank you all so much. Catch you later.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye.